I went from D.C. up to suburban New Jersey, but I saw it all in D.C. I was there during all the bra-burning demonstrations, all the anti-Vietnam demonstrations. I was in the D.C. National Guard for a long time, officiated at a variety of different funerals from JFK all the way up to his brother Robert. It was a very unique period of time in the history of the United States. It was really interesting because it snowed the morning of his inauguration. And of course, being in D.C. at that point in time, they thought they lived in the South, so they didn't have any snow removal equipment. So they called out the D.C. National Guard and gave every one of us snow shovels and set us on Constitution Avenue and said, start shoveling. And that's how we cleared the streets for his inauguration in, I guess that was 1960 or 61. It was pretty interesting. We used to drive up and down the main streets, Independence Avenue, Constitution Avenue, and block to block to block. Each one of them had a different protest going on. The anti-war demonstrations, the bra-burning demonstrations, you name it, they were there. Drive by, see everything, go home and watch it all on the news. Basically, it was a very interesting time in D.C. also, because D.C. was pretty puritanical at the time. They had blue laws. Everything shut down at midnight on Saturday night and didn't open again until Monday. Even the finest of nightclubs and things in D.C., they kicked you out at 12 midnight. Didn't matter who was showing. I saw Flip Wilson in the place called the Shoreham, which had the premier nightclub built into the hotel called the Blue Room. And at 11:30 they came by, said last call. At 11:45 they were stripping the tables. At midnight they turned the lights on. You would have thought you were in Joe Robbie Stadium. That's how bright it got. And you were out the door. That's the way it was back then. The interesting thing was you couldn't walk around in D.C. with a drink. If you went to a restaurant and couldn't be seated, they actually had an employee whose only job it was to carry your drink from the bar to the table because you couldn't carry it. That's all changed now, of course, but it was very interesting. It was an interesting time to be in D.C.
Wow. So the architecture in D.C., you're familiar with it?
Very much so. In fact, I left when they first cut the big hole in Connecticut Avenue to put in the metro.
Wow.
I've never been on the metro, but they started building it the day I left.